Welcome back in this large cab. Let's see how the tractor react at work. There is two ways to drive this transmission. The first one is the manual mode. And after that is very simple to use. The multipad will manage my power shift and my gas pedal will manage my engine revs. Dyna 7 is a semi-power shift transmission with 4 different ranges. We call it 1, 2, 3, 4. And 7 power shift from A to G. When I push my lever, I will increase the gear ratio. When it's blinking, the tractor got the request, but it's not engaged yet. When it's lighted, that means that it's engaged.
Push full notch will increase to power shift. Pull full notch will decrease to power shift.
The second way to use this transmission is the auto mode. We call it as well auto drive.
Press the auto switch on the armrest to switch on the automatic mode or the manual mode. When auto is lighted in green, it means that automatic mode is engaged.
And after that, it's very easy to drive it with the multipad or the pedal, whatever I prefer. The tractor will manage the engine speed by itself.
Few differences in the display for manual or auto mode. In auto drive, the speed is displaying kph and 2 cruise speeds C1 and C2 are available. In manual mode, a transmission ratio is displayed. The blue line indicates the target speed and the white strip increasing indicates the current speed. In both modes, you can lock the transmission in one range to avoid torque interruption. This is very convenient during salty lake, for example. To do so, you need to press the switch at the back of the multipad and move the scroll wheel. A new menu appears with the range segment blue color. You can lock in first, second or third range or select all of them.
Now, let's see how we can change the preset.
Use the scroll wheel to adjust the max speed. The tractor will never go above this value. Push full notch on the multipad to engage max speed in auto drive. To adjust the starting speed, I press this switch on the armrest. Then, I use the scroll wheel to adjust the starting speed. I can set different values for forward or reverse starting speed. If I pull the multipad full notch, it will engage starting speed. I can save the current speed as a cruise speed by pressing for 3 seconds the C1 or C2 button on the multipad. Then, I can adjust the speed using the scroll wheel. Or, using the Datatronic 5, I can enter the cruise speed value I want.
Now we can do the same with the preset 2 and all the settings will be saved in the Datatronic 5 inside the profile. I hope you enjoyed this short video and see you soon for the next episode.